Welcome to another video walk around. Today we're going to be taking a look at this 2016 Volkswagen Jetta TSI in this gorgeous pure white color. This front-wheel drive, four-door, five-passenger sedan comes equipped with a 1.8-liter turbocharged four-cylinder engine mounted to an automatic transmission. Starting out front with some of the notable exterior features, of course you've got that very bright white color, looks fantastic, and of course up front you'll also find the classic Volkswagen emblem with the nice chrome accents that run into these gorgeous headlights. Very sleek design. As you come around to the side of the vehicle, you'll notice the 16-inch alloy rims the vehicle currently rides on, and those are wrapped in the Bridgestone tires, and you can see the tread there. As we continue down the vehicle, you'll notice the turn signal indicator integrated right into the mirror, as well as the nice chrome strip that runs along the bottom of the windows. You've got a very nice compact side profile here. As you come around to the back of the vehicle, you'll notice the roof-mounted antenna stands out with that nice black color against the nice white exterior. Back here, you'll also find, of course, the Jetta badging as well as the TSI badging. Underneath, you'll find the dual exhaust. It looks fantastic and sounds great as well. Overall, this affordable vehicle is a fantastic ride that's packed with features, so let's go ahead and hop inside and take a look at some of the interior bells and whistles. Hopping inside, this Jetta is nice and easy thanks to the remote keyless entry. Simply hit the unlock button on the key fob and you'll be inside. You also notice you've got the trunk release button there, which is really handy, so you can pop the trunk without having to hop inside. And you've also got that nice flip out key. Opening up the door, you're greeted with this very stylish fabric interior here with the nice pattern in the center of the seat. And these are also very, very comfortable and plush seats. And just below here, you will find the manual adjustments for the seat. And if you take a look in the footwell there, you'll find the Jetta branded all-weather mats. And you'll find those throughout the interior. Those are nice and easy to clean, regardless of how dirty or wet they get. So let's go ahead and hop inside, fire this vehicle up, and take a look at all the notable interior features. The features inside this Jetta start over here on the driver's side door panel. You've got a really unique trim just next to the door handle here. It's hard to see on camera, but it does look very nice. Gives the vehicle a nice premium finish. Just below that, you'll find the controls for the power windows, and as an added bonus, all of your windows are one touch down, one touch up automatic. Just above here, you'll also find the controls for the power locks and power mirrors, and as an added bonus, you can flip the switch all the way over to heat your mirrors for those cold winter days, which is a really handy feature. Just underneath here, you do have a little bit of extra storage in the door panel, as well as an extra cup holder, and you'll also find the trunk release button there. Just to the right, you got more of that nice trim as well as the controls for your headlights. And you can see that this vehicle does come with automatic headlights, which is a great set it and forget it feature. And of course, you've also got the dimmer switch for the gauge cluster. Just over on the steering column here, you will find the manual adjustment for your tilt and telescoping steering wheel. And speaking of your steering wheel here, you've got a very nice sporty design with the leather wrap and the flat bottom. You've also got the nice glossy black spokes here, as well as the nice little silver trim around the wheel, and up top you'll find the bolsters, which gives the wheel a nice ergonomic feel. Over on the left hand side here, you've got your cruise controls, which is a really nice feature for the highway driving. And over on the right hand side here, you've got your Bluetooth hands-free calling button, voice recognition button, buttons to navigate the screen in the center of the gauge cluster, and of course you'll also find the track selector buttons. So let's go ahead and take a look up in that screen that I just mentioned. You can see at the top there, you've got the time as well as the gear that the vehicle is in. Below that, you've got the exterior temperature, and then as we continue down, you've got the trip and the odometer, and you can see that this vehicle currently has 91,719 kilometers on it. As we cycle through with the buttons on the steering wheel, you can check your drive time, your average fuel consumption, current fuel consumption, your range, and your digital speedometer. And if we take a look over in the center of the dash here, you'll find a couple of climate vents as well as the passenger airbag warning, and you've also got the hazard lights. Below that, you'll find your touchscreen infotainment system embedded right into the dash here. You've got lots of different options, including your radio. You've also got media, your phone if you have it hooked up via Bluetooth. You've also got the App Connect. And we can also access the media library, your sound, and your setup. So there's lots of different options to go through here, and like I mentioned, for the audio options, you do have your standard AM FM radio. You've also got your CD player, USB and auxiliary inputs, and you've also got an SD card slot and Bluetooth audio, so you can be sure that you can listen to your own audio regardless of the type of device that you have. If we put the vehicle into reverse, you'll notice the backup camera pop right up, which is a really handy feature to have. And putting the vehicle back in a park will bring back your infotainment system. Just below that, you do have the climate controls for the vehicle, and this is a dual-zone climate control vehicle, and it is also automatic, so you can adjust the temperature independently for the driver and the passenger. And if you put it in auto mode, you'll let the vehicle adjust the fan speed and heat to get it to your desired temperature. Up top here, you'll also find the three-stage heated seats for both front passengers, which is a very nice feature for the winter. And as we continue down here, you've got the 12-volt outlet, as well as the USB and auxiliary input that I mentioned, and inside there, you've got a nice carpeted bottom, which would be great to drop your phone on. As we continue down, you've got the shifter with the nice leather boot there, and you've also got the standard mode if you're looking to manually shift between the gears. As we continue down, you've got your nice centrally located parking brake here, as well as a couple of cup holders. And then you got a nice padded armrest in the center here, and of course that opens up to reveal your center console. And you got a nice carpeted bottom in there as well. Over in the passenger side footwell, you've got the same great Jetta branded all-weather mats, and just above here, you've got your standard glove box with lots of room inside, as well as a little tray up top here, which is a really handy feature to help keep things organized. Over on the passenger side door panel there, you've got the same great design that we found on the driver's side, as well as, of course, the controls for the power locks and the passenger side window. Taking a look up top, you'll find the interior lighting controls, as well as the controls for your sunroof, which is a very nice feature to have on sunny days like today. And of course, you can open that up and let in lots of airflow as well. All the way up top here, you'll also find a handy little sunglasses holder. So that concludes the features up front. Let's go ahead and hop in back and take a look at some of the features in the rear of this vehicle. In the rear of this vehicle, you've got more of that same great fabric seating that extends all the way across the rear bench seat, as well as the same great all-weather mats, and you'll also find plenty of legroom for the rear passengers, which is surprising in a sedan of this size. If we hop inside here, you'll also find a couple of handy storage compartments in the back of the center console, as well as a 12-volt outlet to keep the devices charged up for your rear passengers. Back here, you've also got a nice handy storage pocket in the back of the passenger side seat, and if we look towards the center here, you'll find a nice handy fold-down center armrest. It's a nice padded fabric armrest that includes a couple of extra cup holders for your rear passengers. And you've also got a ski pass-through. That is a very nice feature. Makes it nice and easy to store your skis or snowboard or anything long in this vehicle without having to fold the seats down. So we'll go and take a look at where you fold the seats down in just a moment. But before we do, we'll take a quick glance here at the rear door panel, and you'll find the same great design that we found on the front, as well as, of course, a switch for the rear window and a little bit of storage underneath there. So let's go ahead and pop the trunk. We'll use the key fob here, and inside you got a very generous carpeted cargo area here, lots and lots of space, as well as the standard carpet mats if you're looking to switch those out. And you can see that ski pass through that I mentioned, and of course underneath here you will find the spare tire, as well as the tools to change it in case you ever get a flat. Up top here, you'll also find the latches to drop the seats in that 60-40 split that I mentioned. That concludes this short video walk around, but this vehicle is absolutely loaded with features, and there's lots that I didn't get a chance to show you. So make sure you stop by Kelowna Toyota, located at 1200 Leehead Road, or visit us online at kelownatoyota.com for more information. We look forward to seeing you soon.